This crisis makes obvious something that might not have been so visible before. It shows the inequalities that are deeply rooted within society open. It's so sick that now all these underpaid jobs are framed as system-relevant jobs, like the working people on the fields and the cashier person. 70% of this work is done by women. What the fuck? Most of them are working poor or minimum wage. It shows how deeply gender biased are rooted within the society. How do people grow up, learn their skills, do or do not gain access to certain resources, gain access to love and care, gain support in their development? How inequal must a society be that it creates such an outcome where one gender within a society does 70% of a specific work?
And once again, there is so much work that gets invisible in this crisis. I can't hear any more of these politicians talking blah, blah, blah. They are talking about the poor economy, an economy that is unequal. It's the same politicians that in Panama decide on a segregation policy that states that men and women are only allowed to move in public spaces, not together. And in Hungary, where one of the first moves of Orban, this asshole of a dictator, as he got more power through its crisis, was to strip away rights from trans people. So as long as it's not our own economy, as long as not the workers own the company, every one of them should go down. We don't care for airlines and the villas of bosses. Instead, we have to ask questions like, what does it mean for a single parent if all schools are closed down and suddenly this work needs to be done by this person? What does it mean for transnational families if borders are shut down? What does it mean if your partner is in prison and suddenly you're not even allowed to visit? It's so clear. The situation affects so many of us in an intersectional way, some more, some less, some in multiple way.
It would be good to focus on all the unpaid work, work like care and housework that is mostly done by women and queers. It does not need any applause for those who do all this work. It needs good working conditions. We need to own the bakery instead of getting breadcrumbs. And for all who hope that there might be something good coming out of the crisis, where do you get this hope from? What indicates that there is any improvement on the horizon? When did in any of the last crises the situations for women, queers, trans, inter and non-binary people did become significant better? It got better when we did organize. It got better when we did fight. But hope alone did never change stuff.
If we want utopia, we need to give it space.
Utopian ideas are formed in the here and now, somehow present, somehow in the future. They arise from the belief that the current status quo is not the ultimate. Feminist utopias ideas are needed as long as we fight capitalism and all linked forms of exploitation and oppression.
In the fight against patriarchy, there are already utopias being fulfilled though. Ideas that were created to relieve women, queers, inter, trans, non-binary people and people of all genders of living in a so-called patriarchal outside. For example, rooms and houses that function as safe spaces. Rooms of our own, where one can be fragile, wild, loud, or quiet. Rooms in which one feels embraced and without fear of harassment. Safe spaces intend to encourage conversation without risk of physical or emotional harm. This doesn't mean this room excludes cis males or other genders. It invites those who want to be aware of their position in society and are ready to question, to unlearn harmful patterns. Safe spaces provide people with a place free from the seemingly constant hostility going on everywhere else. They can be designed to be empowering or protective or both in one. In short, safe spaces are a little bit revolutionary. And to come back to the beginning, safe spaces, so spaces that are safe for women, queers, inter, trans and non-binary people, haven't always been there. They have been an utopian idea until they had been fought for and realized.
Of course, we can't be satisfied with this. Safe spaces are limited in many ways, not the ultimate. But as long as we live in capitalist, patriarchal, racist, homophobic and so on society, in which spaces, most spaces, are not safe nor welcoming for huge members of beings, we need those safe areas. The current crisis makes very much visible that the vulnerable members in society are affected the most. It shows that having a place to stay home is a privilege. It shows that staying at home doesn't imply of being safe, especially not for women and children. Our reality shows that feminist visions have to go much further and be radical.
And it's not going to be an easy way. To overcome the patriarchy is not just a thing that will happen aside. It needs to get scratched and bitten apart.
Patriarchy and patriarchal structures stand between us and every form of utopia. These power structures, without which capitalism and other forms of oppression would probably not even be conceivable. Patriarchy and patriarchal structures like heteronormativity and sexism prevent that we can define us as independent from categories as sex and gender. These structures don't just let us be, they are creating a fine meshed net made of razor sharp wire.
It's complicated.
There isn't necessarily the good.
There is a broad battlefield.
There are many aspects of interaction and intercourse. It's small and big actions and behavior that has contributed to the patriarchal structures. That does not only need to be unraveled, it needs to be torn apart with sharp claws.
There is no tenderness for the patriarchy.